TFNN. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Just trying to figure out how we got to December so quickly.
I know, and I love... Wait till you see this, folks. The first slide he has is freaking awesome, man. I mean, I love this slide, man. It's
great.
So true.
Great.
And it's unbelievable that we're in December. There's no doubt. I mean, and folks, come to Florida. It's beautiful out right now. It's 82 degrees outside. It's probably like 85 or 87 where you are.
Yeah, we've got a little bit of overcast weather today, but I think once this clears out, then I think we're good for the next, like 10 days or so.
I know.
And this is, October, November, December, January,
yes.
just great months. And it had to be wonderful down in Almorada.
Oh,
I think you guys had great weather, right?
It was beautiful. It was absolutely every day.
Absolutely.
So let's look at this
first
slide.
That's right. This is the first slide out here.
Look at that thing, man.
Hey, have you ever done that? Have you ever gone out to, done any climbing and gone out to the edge of a cliff and looked, way
I've
down?
I've actually up. So in Boston, they had the quarries. When we were kids, we would jump off the quarries, okay? The biggest one I ever did probably was only like 60, 70 feet, but there was one of 100 feet. I never did it, but people do it. Yeah, no, we would, as kids, that's what we used to do.
I have looked over the edge several times, and you're like, you look down there and you're like, woo. Make sure you don't lose your balance.
That's
right?
A fact, man.
Yeah. So last week, it was the markets that were looking out over the edge, and they decided not to jump. And by edge, I'm referring to the weekly TAS market profiles. And it's these green horizontal lines that represent support. And those are the bottom of the weekly profile. So profile, folks, will have a top, which is where sellers reside, a bottom, which is where buyers are at, and then a center, which is where buyers and sellers believe there's fair value in between that range out here. But here, we're just trying to understand, did support hold out there? And this has been the buy the dip area since the March 2020 bottom. So the ES Mini, which is in the upper right hand corner, this shows that when price closes below its profile, that's that red arrow right out here, that has led to a change in trend. But as we take a look at the charts from last week, both for the ES Mini, the Russell 2000, the Dow got really close to the bottom of that profile. They decided not to jump over the edge. And again, we just go back to last year when price did, back in February of 2020, when price did close below the bottom of the profile, that suggested a change in trend, which moved to lower price. And when I take a look at support being hit for any time frame, Tom, but in this case here, we were taking a look at a weekly time frame. I then like to look for bottom signals on the next short time frame. So I go from weekly to daily. If I was doing a daily, I'd be looking at different intraday time frame charts out there. I use a 65-minute chart, a 130-minute chart. And the reason I use those levels or those numbers is because they're equally divisible into the 6.5-hour trading day. And I like my candlesticks that I'm looking at to be equal in time out here. But when we go to a weekly chart, we then go to the daily to see if there's some kind of a bottom pattern. And here inside the S&P 500, we were looking at the ES Mini. The S&P 500 actually formed a Gartley buy pattern, and it did it last week. It did it on Wednesday, I believe, and it did it when it generated this bullish piercing candle. And which is what we can see here. So for me, that's a completed A to B equals CD pattern. And the question is, where should price head to? Well, it should head to this little green line out there, which is at 46.38 for the S&P 500. That's what I refer to as the oscillator and change line. If price is able to close above that, that suggests a further rally. But that's where a counter trend move for the S&P 500 would go to. Now, that number of 46.38 is going to change over the days as price moves up or down. But you can use that as a basic range out there. And if you listen to the Trader's Edge show each day, you'll see those number. The Russell 2000 was also testing that weekly TAS market profile support. So again, we go to, and on a weekly basis, we go to the daily time frame chart. That's what we're looking at. And it completed what I refer to as a TD9 count. And a TD9 count helps us to identify tops or bottoms. In this case here, this was the bottom. It was confirmed. And this is another pattern that I teach the subscribers. You mentioned if you subscribe to the newsletter, there's a number of archive workshops, and it will teach you about this pattern. This is really a great pattern to learn and understand. So in this case here, we're looking at the Russell 2000, the cash indices. It too should bounce up to its oscillator and change line, which when I generated this chart earlier in the day, Tom, was about 22.54. Like the Russell 2000, the Dow also formed a TD9 count bottom last Wednesday, and that's what we're looking at here. Now, the Dow, I'm just looking at the futures contract, so it should be trading above the 35.169 level as we speak, and a close above this, so this is where a counter trend rally for the Dow should stop. So if it closed back below 35.169 today or thereabouts, that would have me a bit concerned. If it can close above this level, that is telling us that it wants to target the 35.952 area. And that is using this TD9 count system, and that identifies for us where price broke down. So we've got three of the four that have bottoms, and that leaves the NDX 100 as the final index that needs to form a bottom pattern. I took this snapshot probably about 10 minutes ago. And again, what I'm looking for here, folks, is I've got an A to B equals CD to the downside pattern. Those blue diagonal lines out there. But for me, in order for the pattern to complete, it completes when the cavalry arrives, and the cavalry would be defined as seeing some type of bullish reversal candle, a bullish engulfing candle, a piercing candle, a hammer candle, Three River Morning Star. There's a couple others that we would look at. So not until that forms will we get all four indices in alignment with each other. Price is holding support, a level of support, and that's the breakout level. And again, this is the TD9 count pattern that helps us identify breakout levels and breakdown levels. So price has pulled back to the breakout area, and that can be the sign of a bottom, Tom. But because there's an A to B equals CD to downside, my preference is to wait for that bullish reversal candle. The NASDAQ composite, on the other hand, the larger, the NASDAQ 100's got 108 instruments maybe inside it. The NASDAQ composite, some like 3,500 instruments. It completed a TD9 count. So it's telling us that the general instruments inside the NASDAQ should suggest a rally. The NASDAQ composite may be targeting 15,623. So we began our review looking at the weekly profiles. For upside price targets, we can also look to the daily time frame. Now, these are the equity futures contracts, and this will be important for those folks that do track the equity future contract. The ES should target the 46.49 level. 46.49 is the bottom of its daily profile, the center of its bearish structured daily profile, and the center of its bearish structured weekly profile. So that's going to be a real key level of resistance. The NQ should target 16.134. If we get a bullish reversal candle, that's the real level. Look, 16.134, Tom, is the real key level. This is a bullish structured profile, and when price breaks through that, counter trend rallies typically end at that center level, 16.134. That'll be the make or break point as to whether this is just a counter trend rally or not. So markets looked over the edge. They decided, hey, I'm not going to jump just yet, and now price should head higher.
You got to love a two-way market, man.
There's
no doubt. Market, right? Listen, folks, it's very easy to get Steve's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You can see right under featured content. You hit that button and you are off to the races. Steve, you have a great one, safe one. Great update. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom.
Thanks,
Take
man.
Care.
Have a great one. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
All right, Tigers and Tigresses, that's the end of the video. If you learned something or are interested in more fundamental topics to better hone your investing skills, click the subscribe button and stay tuned. We offer a live stream every trading day from open to close, so drop by to gather some insights on the market for the day. And if you have any questions, make sure to ask them in the chat. Come visit us at tfnn.com and check out our great newsletters, released multiple times a week from our lineup of highly seasoned traders.